afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are Pine Capital. Today, we're presenting to you our coverage of Star Limited, as well as the reasons behind our sell call and $2.60 target price. StarHub is an info communications service provider operating in Singapore, a country that is small but advanced. In Singapore, literacy and tax rates are amongst the most competitive globally, with most of the population also adopting social media and other mobile technologies. To cater to this advanced market, StarHub offers its customer services from all four of these segments. Mobile remains its key driver of revenue and the highest contributor to the bottom line. While investors have traditionally flocked to StarHub because of its high and attractive dividend yield, we believe that these returns are not sustainable, as StarHub will soon come under attack by new entrants. Some investors might believe that these new developments have already been priced in, as stock prices have fallen in the past few months. However, we believe that this is due to the strong correlation that StarHub has with the market index. Since the possibility of a fourth telco was announced, StarHub has indeed fallen by 16%. However, over that same period, the market index also fell by 12%. Reflecting abnormal StarHub-specific falls of a mere 6.4%.
Our first thesis is the entry of a fourth telco. StarHub is the second largest player in the Singapore telecoms industry. It commands a market share of 27% in the mobile segment. The industry is regulated by the IDA, which has a pro-competition stance. It has taken multiple measures in an attempt to bring a fourth telco into the industry. It has completed two public consultation exercises over the past 3 years and has recently completed a mobility trial for a fourth entrant. In addition, it has also taken the unprecedented step of reserving spectrum rights and steep discounts for a new operator. Coupled with strong interest shown by the market, we believe that a fourth telco will enter the Singapore industry. The new entrant will result. Singapore telcos have historically had high average revenue per user, or ARPU. However, this will not last when the fourth telco enters. We forecast that industry-wide ARPU will decline to $38 in 2021. A fourth telco will also result in loss of market share for StarHub. Historical case studies suggest that new operators tend to stabilize at a 10% market share. We believe that this will translate into a 3% market share loss for StarHub by 2021. A new operator will also result in spectrum scarcity in the upcoming spectrum rights auction. The regulator has reserved 40% of the available low-frequency spectrum for a new operator. This will result in less spectrum available for existing telcos, driving up bidding prices. We expect StarHub to incur over $400 million in capex in 2017. Combined, we expect the impact of a fourth telco to reduce the stock price by 50 cents.
Typically, a Singaporean has a two-year bundle plan with one telco consisting of mobile, broadband, and pay TV services. This results in the stickiness of the plan, preventing them from changing telco. Incumbents are therefore left in a comfortable position with consistently low churn rates across all segments. However, this is set to change with the rise of over-the-top OTT services, creating a structural decline in the industry. OTT services put pressure on existing infrastructure, threatening revenue. Voice OTT such as WhatsApp and Telegram has replaced SMS and voice calls. This can be seen in StarHub's voice services as a percentage of postpaid ARPU declining from 61% to 47%. Video OTT has begun replacing traditional cable TV through the lease of internet. Under Singapore Next Generation Broadband Initiative, all telcos can now tap into the same fiber infrastructure. This levels the playing field, and along with household fiber access improving to 62% in 2014, consumers can now easily mix and match services from different telcos, weakening their ability to bundle. This can be seen in the tapering growth of triple play households in StarHub's 2015 annual report. we expect cable to slow down to less than 1% in the next few years. We also expect these to have a 12 cents impact on share price. Moving on to the next thesis, Singapore is a fast adopter of new technology due to its Smart Nation plan. As such, telcos cannot delay the implementation of new mobile technologies. Advancing from 2G to 4G, some customers to stay on the old 2G network. This forces StarHub to maintain its old base station, adding to cost pressures. On top of that, StarHub also has to sustain cable and fiber infrastructure. As subscribers move from cable to fiber, StarHub transits from a fully depreciated fixed cost model to a variable cost model, with no economies of scale. Until cable lease expires in 2020, dual infrastructure upkeep is expected to pressure margins. With half of StarHub subscribers on fiber, we expect a 12.1% annual fiber migration rate to sustain cost pressures at 4.5% cable. In addition, the aspiration of $60 million in